In this update to Onshape, you can now dynamically control the suppression of features using expressions. In this example, you may want to change the suppression of various members based on the overall size of the frame. To drive a feature suppression with an expression, right-click on the feature and select Dynamic Suppression, then choose Add Expression. In the dialog box, create an expression stating when the feature should be unsuppressed. In this case, anytime the overall width of the frame is equal to or greater than 1500 millimeters. Likewise, you can use this to control the suppression of patterns. For example, anytime the length of the frame exceeds 3000 millimeters, we want to change the side braces from 2 instances to 4. You can further parametrically drive your designs by including these expressions in your configurations. You can even turn any already configured suppression into an expression by right-clicking on it and selecting Convert to Expression. From there, the process is the same as before, writing an expression to specify when the configured feature should be unsuppressed. In this case, whenever the medium duty option is selected, all of the gussets will only be unsuppressed when the length of the frame exceeds 3000 millimeters. Dynamic feature suppression provides more ways to parametrically drive and add greater intelligence to your designs.
Onshape simulation now includes angular velocity loads for analysis of rotating components. In this example, we'll analyze the blades of this coffee grinder. Simply select the angular velocity load from the top ribbon and apply it to the grinder blades. We'll also select the rotational frame of reference, here being certain to choose the same direction as the shaft's revolute mate. Loads can be applied in degrees or radians per second or RPM as defined by your workspace unit's settings. Once applied, Onshape converts the angular velocity into the corresponding inertial loads to act upon the grinder blades. Now we can solve the simulation. This particular example only took a few seconds to complete, but as always with Onshape simulation, we can preview the results while the simulation still runs. Displacements here are shown in the blade's accelerated frame of reference, similar to results from an inertial relief. With the analysis in hand, we can now move forward with confidence in our design. You can now show the locations of the minimum and maximum value on your simulation results. From the right side simulations panel, under Legend, select Show Minimum or Show Maximum. A callout is shown on screen. This callout correctly shows for each different type of results you select.
Today we're introducing new user-defined graphics preferences in Onshape. You can now adjust line width, surface shininess for better surface analysis, as well as the specular color of the light source to really highlight what you're looking at when performing that analysis, as well as the field of view, which you can modify if perspective mode is turned on. You'll see here I can go down from 20 all the way up to a very wide angle here. These preferences are saved to your user profile, so once you set them, they become the default everywhere in Onshape. And if you ever want to go back, you can restore the graphic settings to the defaults anytime. It also looks great in dark mode. Onshape has improved its assembly graphics, making them sharper and more responsive as you zoom in. This update enhances the detail of parts, resulting in cleaner surfaces and edges, especially useful for inspecting imported geometry with coarse refinement. Now, zooming in triggers a high-quality representation without needing manual adjustments. However, be aware that actions from collaborators can temporarily reduce graphics resolution, and transparent parts won't refine when zoomed in.
Onshape now gives you easier control and more choices when it comes to positioning the views in your drawings. The previous options for rotating a view have been moved to a new right-click submenu called Rotate View. Simply specify if you want to rotate the view horizontally or vertically, and then select Geometry from the view to reference the alignment. This is not only easier than manually specifying the rotation angle, it's ideal when you do not know how much to rotate the view. You can now also align views to one another from the Align Views right-click menu. Specify if you want to align a view vertically or horizontally, then select the view you want to align with. Like all Align Views in Onshape, you can make adjustments to any view in the alignment chain, and all of the associated views will move appropriately. At any time, if you want to break the alignment, right-click on the view, choose Align Views, and you will now have the options to remove any alignments added to the view. These new rotation and alignment options give you complete control over the layout of your drawings in Onshape. Driving dimensions on drawings are useful for defining sketch geometry not included in the 3D model. Onshape now enables you to define the precision of the decimal places and specify the tolerance of driving dimensions in drawings. You can also use the format painter in drawings to copy this information from other dimensions onto these dimensions now. This capability gives you more choices when detailing your drawings in Onshape. Onshape now supports inferencing horizontal and vertical relationships while sketching in a drawing. This also works within other tools that require sketching, like the hatch command as well. This will make adding sketch geometry in drawings easier to locate and add relationships. Now, when you obsolete a revision in Onshape and that item has an associated part, assembly, or drawing that references the same part number, you will be presented with a warning notifying you that the associated object may need to be added to the obsolete candidate. Once you add the associated part, assembly, or in this case, drawing, the notification will be removed, letting you know that you've included the missing reference.
Today, I am going to show you the new Onshape Enterprise Slack integration and how it keeps your entire team connected to design activity without switching apps. With this integration, Slack becomes an extension of your Onshape Enterprise environment. Comments, tasks, and release activity flow directly in the Slack, and you can respond instantly from wherever you are. Let's start with comments. Anytime someone creates a comment in Onshape, it automatically appears in Slack under the app section, similar to the Slack bot. You can reply in line inside of Slack, and your response is instantly written back into the Onshape comments panel. That means design conversations stay in context. Next, release notifications. When a release candidate is created in your enterprise, the approvers are notified directly in Slack. The Slack message reflects the state of the release at the moment it was created and includes a button labeled Review Release. Clicking that button opens Onshape in your browser directly in the release candidate screen where you can perform the actual actions, review details, comment, update the package, release, reject, or discard, and so on. The integration also gives you quick access to your Onshape tasks. A simple command displays your recent tasks inside of Slack. Each task includes a hyperlink back to the task in Onshape. Today, we're taking a look at AXF Appearances in Render Studio Advanced, your gateway to using real physically measured materials directly inside of Onshape. AXF, or Appearance Exchange Format, is a material standard created by X-Rite scanning devices. Unlike texture maps, an AXF file captures the full optical behavior of a material, color, gloss, reflectance, and even spatial variation. It's widely used in automotive, industrial design, and consumer product development because it provides a true measured-based representation of real materials. In the selected AXF dialog, click Import, choose your AXF file, and it's applied instantly. Once assigned, the Appearance panel updates with controls specific to the AXF file type. Render Studio supports several types of AXF files. Depending on the material, you can adjust many different parameters. With AXF support built into Render Studio Advanced, you can achieve high-quality, measurement-based materials right in your browser, bringing unmatched realism to your Onshape designs. Render Studio just got a major boost in navigation speed, especially when working with large, complex scenes that contain thousands of parts like this one. The update dramatically accelerates bounding box navigation, letting you move through massive assemblies with great responsiveness. Now, with augmented reality and scanning all on the same device, Onshape is capable of placing objects directly where they were designed in a scanned environment. So if we take a look at this, I'm just scanning my tool chest here, getting corners and walls here all kind of scanned up inside of Onshape on my iPad Pro, and it's generating an environment scan. From that environment scan, I can go ahead and create general objects or create an assembly and start assembling things to this scan that I could bring into my assembly as well. In this case, I'm just going to create a three-point plane and start constructing some geometry directly on the scan. Three-point plane is a great way of achieving that, of course. So let's go ahead, create a couple of objects here. I'm just going to create a box and another box on top of it, hollow it out. Now I'm going to go back to my iPad and turn on AR view underneath the view cube here. So I'll go to AR view, go back to my tool chest, and automatically the scan appears directly where I designed it.